Jo Swinson may be a boxing novice, but she's taking a big swing at Brexit. Despite the unmistakable message voters sent to Westminster in 2016.
52% to 48% nationwide in favor of Brexit.
Swinson, the fresh-faced leader of the centrist Liberal Democrats, is aiming to capitalize on the central issue of the election campaign, Brexit. She's courting the 48% who voted to remain by pledging to cancel Brexit altogether, revoking the Article 50 process, no debate, no vote.
This is a democratic election now, and people can make a choice. And if they want to stop Brexit, as Liberal Democrats, we're standing up for what we believe is the right position.
Do you not respect the 52% of people who voted to leave the EU, or do you just think that you know better than them?
I respect them, and I respectfully disagree with them.
Swinson's party is polling a distant third nationally, but hopes to do better after making a pact with two smaller pro-Remain parties, who've agreed not to stand against each other in 60 constituencies, all to consolidate the Remain vote. The Green Party is part of that pact, but candidate Caroline Lucas is no fan of Swinson's plan to cancel Brexit without a vote.
If you just want to put your headphones on a second, I want to play you a clip.
He wanted to send a message to 17.4 million people, but you don't give a f*** about what they just said. Why don't you just say so?
Caroline Lucas, you potty mouth.
Well, to be in my defence, I didn't realise that bit was being recorded. So, although I stand by the sentiment...
On his call-in radio show, host Ian Dale regularly gets an earful from voters who feel like it's the political establishment and the country's elites calling the shots, not them.
There isn't a centre-left party that hasn't betrayed the vote that the referendum campaign called for.
The people who lost the referendum can't really bear it. They think the people who voted for Brexit were stupid, sick, racist, whatever. And they just haven't come to terms with that result. And I'm afraid, I don't think they ever will.
And it's not just Swinson. Dale thinks politicians of all stripes have spent the last 3 years only pretending to move ahead on Brexit.
What they're actually doing is subverting democracy, and it's a very dangerous game that they're playing.
But they're not very subtle anymore.
Some are more subtle than others.
Subtlety, it seems, is no longer required. Only one major party, Conservative, has promised to follow through with Brexit. The Scottish National Party has vowed to remain, and the opposition Labour Party wants a second referendum. So while Swinson's odds of becoming Prime Minister are long, she doesn't need to win outright to derail Brexit.
I wonder what kind of precedent you think that sets for democracy.
There will be a lot of people that withdraw from the democratic process altogether. They will think, what is the point of voting if the politicians and the elites in Westminster don't respect that vote?
Scott McLean, CNN, London.